Last week, Anderson talked about a new federal rule keeping cameras at least 65 feet back from oil booms and response vessels. He's also highlighted BP's efforts at keeping cameras and reporters away, even though top BP officials are now publicly urging openness. We are not the enemy, he said. Well, tell that to the BP security officer, the local cop, and the man who said he was a Homeland Security agent outside of BP's refinery in Texas City, Texas. They all detained our next guest, photographer Lance Rosenfield, demanded his ID and wouldn't let him go until they took a look at the pictures he took. Texas City, you recall, is the site of a deadly explosion back in 2005, one that some believe shares certain similarities with the Deepwater Horizon blast. Lance Rosenfield, who was taking pictures on behalf of the news organization ProPublica, joins us now. Lance, nice to talk to you. Tell me what happened. You were taking photos outside of that refinery that we just discussed. The police came up to you. What do they say?
After I took the pictures, I drove for about 3 miles, pulled into a gas station, and I was tailed that entire time by a security truck. When I pulled in, the security truck continued on. The police pulled in, and they asked to see the photographs on my camera. And I said, without a warrant, I'm not bound to do that. And they said, well, we can take you in, and you can do it there with Homeland Security, or you can show us now. And I was on deadline, so I showed them the pictures at that time.
I should mention that we're looking at some of the pictures that you took as you're telling me what happened. So you show them the pictures, and what happens?
The police basically determined that there was no threatening, there were no pictures that posed a threat to the refinery. And then he took my information, my personal information, and the police officer was essentially finished at that point. The BP security guard showed up at that point and asked me for my personal information, and I declined because he's a corporate security guard. And he turned to the police officer, who then turned over all my personal information. And I protested. I said I didn't understand under what legal grounds he was able to give him my personal information.
Well, I'm going to ask you a question about that in a moment. But first, I just want to tell you what the BP folks said to us when we called. They said this, quote, normally, if a photographer identifies himself, there's no problem. But he, meaning you, was an unknown photographer, and our security alerted the authorities. Do you think that the BP folks were doing their job? Do you think they were kind of going overboard? What's your take on it?
No, I mean, I think, I certainly was taking pictures in the public street of a public sign, but it was near the refinery. I can understand the fact that if they saw me through their security cameras or whatnot, that they would be interested in why I was taking pictures near the refinery. That part I don't have a problem with. What I do have a problem with is why the local police turned over my personal information to the BP officer.
And what did he say when you asked him that? Because that, to me, sort of sounds like the police was acting in coordination with the private security firm hired by BP.
Right.
So when you asked him, what did he say?
He didn't give an answer. He said, well, we're going to do it anyway, whether you like it or not, and we can call our Homeland Security officer, Tom Robison, to come down here and explain it, but, you know, this is what I'm going to do anyway. And he didn't give me an answer. And then he did call Tom Robison.
who came down. Eventually, you left town right after the incident, and I know you said you felt somewhat threatened when their Homeland Security officer came by. Is that why you left town? Is that what happened?
Yes, it seemed to me that the issue was finished with the officer and the security guard. But then once Homeland Security officer came, Tom Robison, it seemed like his only point of being there was to intimidate me. And I realized at that point that I had been there for 24 hours. I had done the bulk of the assignment that I was hired to do. I called my editors, explained what happened, and we all agreed that, for all intents and purposes, the assignment was finished. And it wasn't worth going through more harassment if I were going to continue the assignment.
You've gotten an attorney, though. I think the ACLU, an ACLU attorney, is representing you. What does that mean? You're going to sue?
No. All I've done is I've emailed ACLU, but I actually haven't heard back from them yet.
So
the ProPublica's attorney I did speak to after the incident occurred.
You consider it closed, or do you want to pursue it further?
I mean, I'd be curious to have a conversation. I would like to have a conversation with ACLU. I really don't want this happening to other journalists. I mean, I don't think that we deserve to be harassed. I did nothing outside the law. I never entered BP property, and I didn't deserve to be harassed and detained for as long as I was.
All right, well, we'll keep an eye on what happens with your case, if it does become a case. Lance Rosenfield, thanks for talking with us. Appreciate it.
Sure, thanks.
Coming up next, where the oil is headed now as Texas becomes the latest target. Also, the weather that's threatening to bring new trouble to the Gulf. Chad Miles will join us with the early warning. Stay with us.